Then you go to folder, and then that is how you can create your LaTeX folder. So I will give you 2 minutes to just do that. So maybe you can complete this task.
Okay. Sir, excuse me.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Sir, yes. This message is actually coming again and again for last almost for 1 year on my screen. That something has went wrong. Something has went wrong. Sir, why something is actually going wrong here in the LaTeX?
Regarding what you are trying to do when it shows that something
sir,
has
just
gone wrong.
Just right now, just right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
On your screen, a message did arrive that
yeah.
something has went wrong, right?
In my screen, no, not on my screen.
Sir, I guess that was on your screen, on your desktop I'm talking about,
no.
When you are going to open the LaTeX.
No, everything is okay. From my side, everything is okay.
You have just clicked that no button.
I am sorry, I am not able to understand what you are trying to say, actually. I didn't get any such.
As the video is being recorded, we can find from that as well. No issue. I will definitely discuss
yeah, okay.
you on that point. If
okay.
you please be merciful to me. Thank you very much.
Sure. Yeah. So what you can do now is that you can go to this particular folder and you can create another folder here. Let us call that as day one. Okay. So what we will do now is, because this is our first day, you will save all our files in this particular folder, which we have called as day one. Okay. I hope this is a very simple task for all of you. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write something here and then I will save this file in that day one folder. So let me just press Control S. And when I press Control S, now you can see that this screen is appearing. I will go to desktop, LaTeX 2020, day one. And now what I will do is I will write this as first document. And because it can save as different types of files, therefore I will also write .tex. So as you can see that the file name now is first document.tex. So
hello. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you repeat the process? Just on the internet and we have the power here. So power came in here.
Please talk one by one. I'm sorry. Yeah.
I'm Satish. I am saying that. Can
yeah.
you repeat the process?
Yeah, Satish. You can. What you can do is you can open Text Studio. Have you
yes,
created
sir.
These folders? Have you created these folders?
Yeah,
yes,
folder
yes.
in the desktop.
Okay, LaTeX 2020, day one. All right.
Yes,
and
fine.
Then on this, someone speaking. All right. So what you can do, you open your Text Studio, you press Control N, which is for
yes.
a new file. All right.
Okay.
And then you
yes,
press
sir.
Control S. Okay.
Control.
And you will
yes,
press
sir.
Control S. Then you can save your file. What I want you to do is you go to that folder of day one, and then
yes,
you
sir.
Save this file by the name first document.tech.
Okay, okay.
Is it okay?
Thank you, sir. Okay, sir.
All right. So let us create our first document. So you can maybe follow along. You press backslash document class. Now you see, I have just typed backslash docu. All right. And it is giving me some option. Now, if I simply press enter, then it will insert everything for me. Now, what kind of document class we are preparing is article. So I will simply type article. Okay. Next, what I will do is I will begin document. Right. And I will write my first document, my first, and I will write it like this. LaTeX. And I will save it. So if you have typed it, well and good. If you are not able to do that, I am pasting all of these things into the chat box where you can simply copy and paste into your text editor. The IDE, I mean. All right. So it is now available in your
text editor. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
I'm Swati from Bangalore.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a question.
I have a question. Can you define any other article, article is a document file. Other than article, can we define other kind of document like notice or?
Yes. Ma'am, this is just for illustration purposes. I am not actually going to go into the details of the article because all these things will be covered later on. And okay. We will cover several types of document, not just.
Hello?
So please wait for something. Yes.
Sir, sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, but sir, as I am writing down on my text studio or text mm-hmm. studio, at this time, do I need to get my mid text console open or no, it is actually no. working on the background on my
it
system?
Is,
I don't need to open it.
It will work whenever you will compile. It will only work at that particular time. You don't have to worry about it.
No, I'm not telling that. I'm actually asking that. I have actually opened the text studio on my desktop, but I have not actually opened the mic text at all. Okay, mic text console at all.
That is
so
what
do
I'm
I need
saying.
To open the mic text console as well, or I mean it is already working on the background?
The mic text console is there. It is not personal. It is not working right now. It will only work whenever you will compile your document. We will come to compilation.
Okay, but I do not need to click on the mic text console at all.
No. You that is done. You
okay,
don't
thank
have to
you
worry
very
about
much,
it.
Sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I'm disturbing a lot. Please don't mind, sir.
No, it's okay. That is what this session is for. All right. So I hope that all of you are ready with this particular document. Now what I want you to do is I want you to click here. You can see that it says build and view, and on the side it is written as F5. So either you can click on this or you can press F5, and then what will happen is if I click on this, then you can see that it has created this document for me, which says my first LaTeX document. Okay. So I hope all of you are available, all of you were able to do that. If your MikTeX has been installed and configured correctly, then this document will appear on this side. Okay. And if I press here, then you can see that I can zoom in to my document. So I can see it in much more detail over here. Okay. Let us see that what are the features of this particular software. Okay, so that is what this interaction session is about. As I said, that I am not going to explain you that how to insert figures, how to insert tables, all these things I am not going to tell you. Other people and in other sessions, all these things will be covered. But I just want to show you that what are the features of this particular software. That's all I want to do right now. Okay, so if you have any question regarding how to do this or how to do that, you don't have to ask right now because I'm not covering that. And we have not told you also that what is the meaning of document class, what is begin document, what is end document, all those things I have not covered because they will be covered in due time. Okay, so let us go over to the features of this particular software. First of all, we'll go through the menu. And these menus also, I'm not going to cover too much. I will just point out few things which may be very useful for you for while using this software. And other parts will be covered by other people, other instructors, whenever they are giving their own lectures or whenever you are attending the tutorial sessions, then those things will be covered in much more detail. But for the time being, I'm just highlighting what are the main things that are available in this particular software. So let us go over that. The file menu is pretty standard. You can create new files. You can create new files from the template. So if I create new file from template, then you can see that this is the list that I'm getting. Okay. Now if I, let us say I click on article and if I press okay, then you see that everything, it will type it for me. It has said that your document class is article. You can give your title. You can give your author. It will make title, then you can give your abstract, you can give your section. Okay, so let me write something. You can write your own name here. For example, if I write, let me simply write Abhinav here. Okay, that should have been the author actually. So you can do it alone. You can simply fill for example, first document I'll write it, okay, and abstract is I have done word changing work. All right, section, let us call it as first section, something like this, or and I will write some random text. Now if I again do the same thing, if I, okay, so this is a new file, you can see that it has named as untitled. All right, so if I simply save this, let us say as second document instead of first document. I will save it, okay, and I can obviously run it by either by pressing F5 or by pressing this particular button. So when I do that, my first document will appear on this particular side. You can see here. Okay, so this way templates can be very, very helpful for you when you don't want to remember all these things of document class and title and author, where they should go, what kind of command I should give. All these things can be done by going here new from template. You can do that. Okay, so that is a very good feature. And not just article, as you can see, that you can create many, many other things. So that was just an example for you to show you that how to use these templates. Another important thing is that you can make your own template. For example, when you will learn enough of LaTeX, then you will start creating more and more complex documents, and you want that particular preamble to always appear in your document. Then what you can do is you can click on make template, and then you can do everything whatever you want to do. Okay, and then that template will be available when you click new from template. So this way you can use this particular feature of template. Rest of the things I'm not going to cover. Hopefully you will realize all these things in due time. When we go to edit, in edit also, I don't think that I have much to say. All right. I don't have to go through all these things much. One important thing in this IDE fix you can see is that of a toggle comment. What toggle comment does is that, for example, you can see that this line has been commented. You will realize this again and again, that you will always want to comment and uncomment. So either you can go to this IDE fix, or what you can do is you can press either Control T toggles. If it is commented, it will uncomment it. If it is uncommented, then it will comment it. That means again, if I press Control T, it will comment it. You can see it here. If I again press Control T, then it will uncomment it, as you can see here. So this is a very, very handy shortcut that you can use. Next, we have tools. In this tools also, I'm not going to go to the details of all this, but here what you have is that there are several commands available here. Okay. And generally we are using PDF LaTeX. So this, you don't have to do anything here, but there are some certain important things here. You can see that build and view. This is the most important thing you will always do. And there is a shortcut for that, which is F5. So you can always use this F5 shortcut. Sometimes what may happen is that your PDF will be gone. For example, like this, you can see now that your PDF has disappeared. Now what you do is either you go to tools and you click on view, your PDF will appear. Okay. Or you can, what you can do is you can simply press F7. Again, your PDF will appear on the right hand side. So this is a handy shortcut that you can use to view PDF and to compile and view your document. Next, what we have is this LaTeX menu bar. In this, as you can see, that there are several things which are available here, which will be very, very helpful for you. And hopefully, whenever you are doing the practice sessions, you will use all these things. For example, different font styles, font sizes, tabular environment, and all these things are available. That you can do for yourself, or you will do it in the practice session. The same thing is true for math also. There are several options which are available here, which you can use different functions, you can use different font styles and things like that. You can use accents, math spaces are there. You can use all these things. This is very, very important, this wizard. This wizard is very similar to Tabular, but it has some more features. So what this wizard does is, let us say that you want to create a Beamer presentation. Even though Beamer presentation is going to come later on, but what you do is you click on this quick Beamer presentation. It will show you the output on the right hand side also. Here you just change the theme, for example, like this. You can see whether you like it or not, or you can change it a little bit different, like this, and so on. Okay, but Beamer will be covered later on, and I think Dr. Arvind is going to cover that, and he will explain more that how to use this particular wizard. It makes your life very, very simple. You don't have to remember all the commands all the time. So this wizard is very, very important, and this wizard is important not only for this, but you can insert tabular environments, array, graphics also, you can do that. Okay, so how to use graphics? Okay, let me just copy some figure and then maybe we can use that. It will not work on your computer because you will not have that particular graphics file, but let me show you how it works. Here is a figure of Einstein, let us say. All right, so I will copy this file in this particular day one folder, and now what I can do is I can go to this wizard and insert graphic. In this insert graphic, I can choose the file that I want to insert, which is this particular file. Okay, I can choose the width. I will choose a width of 0.3, let us say. Okay, I can give it a name. This is a photo of Einstein. Okay, it has given the label by itself. I will not go into the details of it, but if I press OK, then you can see that it is telling me that I should use this particular package of use graphics. Let me bring it to the next line. So what I will do is I will copy this and I will paste it here. And it has done everything for me. Now if I press this, then my graphics will appear. Okay, so the graphics has appeared here, but now you might.
So can you please repeat this step?
It is you cannot perform it right now, but what I am saying is that you can go to wizard, you can go to insert okay. graphic. Okay, now you can choose the file that you want to insert by pressing on this particular icon. Okay, if okay. I press this, then it will ask me to choose my file. I can choose my file. I'm not going to choose right now because I've already done that.
Yes.
Okay. I will give some caption for it. Okay. Yeah. Some whatever text I want to write. Okay. It will create a label for me automatically, and then I will press OK.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
When I do that, then what it will
so just do a minute. Is... So just a minute. The photo is actually on the very center of our document. If I want to get it shifted to leftward, rightward, or sometimes within the text, or behind the text, so is there that kind of option available as well?
That is, all of these things will be taught to you in due course of time. But I am just here showing okay. you the use of the software, not the typesetting of the document actually.
Okay, sir.
So that will be thank you very much. That will be discussed in due course of time. Okay. All right. So let us go ahead and what else do we have? So bibliography I'm not going to cover because whenever there is a time for bibliography, then we will explain that what all these things are, how to use them, and all those things we will discuss when we will discuss about bibliography. Now this macro is a very, very important thing. I'm not going to explain you how to write macros actually, but I will just show you that what is the use of this particular macro. For example, I have here is this macro which is known as Excel to Tabular, and what this does is that you write your table in Excel format, you click there, and it will insert a tabular environment into your LaTeX document, and you don't have to do anything. Okay, so let me just show you how it works. So let me go here, and what I will do is I will create some table. So let me do that. So what I will do is I will write some here, something here. Let us say I write name and I say Abhinav. Okay. And all right, first maybe I can write it first, then second name, and then the third name, right? Surname. So let me just try to. Okay. Now what I do is I simply copy it. And then I go here and I click on this particular macro. So you can see that it has inserted the whole macro for me. Now, if I run this particular file, then you will see that this table will appear in this particular LaTeX document, as you can see. Okay, now how to change, how to style all this table, etc., that will be covered later on. But I'm just showing you the power of macro, that what macro can do for you. There are other macros. I'm not going to cover that because I just want to show you some basic features of all this. So I'm not going to cover that. Then this view is there. It is not, it's okay, right? For example, I have several tech files open here. If I want to search or if I want to switch to some other document, then what I have to do is I have to go and press there. But instead, what you can do is you can press Control and page up, page down. Then you can simply cycle through all these documents using Control, page up, page down. Okay, so you can try if you have opened any particular file, then you can see that this shortcut will be very, very helpful for you because you don't have to go to your mouse and click there. You simply can press Control, page up, page down, and then you can cycle through all your open documents.
So this command begin tabular appears by itself?
Yeah, it appears by itself, but it will not appear in your text editor because you don't have this macro. Okay?
Yes, we don't have, yes.
Yeah. I'm just saying that you can do wonderful things with macro. It is just an exhibition that what can be done using macros. You may have to go to more details to learn how to actually create macros. I'm not doing that right now. That is what I'm saying. Yeah. Okay. So view is, I'm not going to view, but this option is very, very, it can be very important. For example, your Text Studio will look very different as compared to my Text Studio. And why that is the case? Because I've changed the font. I've changed the font type, I've changed the font size, and things like that I've done. Okay, so all these things can be configured using this option of options. Okay, so you can change your fonts here. For example, you can see that this general font is, for example, MS Sans Serif. The font size, etc., you can change. You can change the language also. Maybe your language is not English. Then what you have to do is you have to come here and then you can change your default language to EN. Okay, now your language will be EN. Different commands you can change. For example, I told you that all the commands we are going to run will be PDF LaTeX, as you can see here. Okay, but there are several options to PDF LaTeX which I have not covered. I can come and put all these options here. If I want to use something else, some other command I want to use, then I can come and change over here. Then we have this build. Okay, make sure that this is how what your setup looks like, that this should be compile and view, this should be PDF LaTeX and things like that. There are several shortcuts. I will not go into that. In the editor, you can change the font family. You can change the font size. That is what I have done. That is why my font family I have chosen is Cascadia code because I like that this particular font. Okay, and the font size is 12. If I want to make it bigger, for example, if I can make maybe make it 14 or things like that. And what I always like is that I want line numbers to appear on the left hand side. That is why what I have done is here the option is show line numbers. Here you can see that I have selected all line numbers, so that I can see the line numbers here on the left hand side. So I hope you get the idea that what this does. I'm not going into too much details of every option. So I will leave it for you to explore. Whenever you are done with changing, you have to just press OK. Yes.
Sir, I mean, would you please be kind to go to the very first command you wrote? I mean, on the very first command, my first LaTeX document. Okay, my first LaTeX document. Sir, I'm actually writing down just similarly, but I don't know that, I mean, why here it's not working.
I have copied and pasted this in the chat box. You can go and see in the chat box, copy from there.
Okay.
And then try.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I have also done that. But let me tell you this thing. Oh, no, no, no. Sir, this time it is okay. I guess there was some space issue. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay, so I'm not going, as I said, I've already discussed these options. I'm not going into the details of all of these things because we don't have sufficient time. Now let me go to one of the very important features of this particular text editor, which is help. Because you don't know all of LaTeX, you will always require help and Google will always help you. But I just want to tell you that the help is available right inside your IDE. So if I go to help and I click on this LaTeX reference, then what it will do is, it will open this web browser, whatever is your default web browser. Then you can see that all the help that you want is available over here. Okay, so whenever you want to look at anything, for example, let us say math formula I want to see. Okay, so it will give you several options, like for example, how to make subscript and superscript. So you will get all the help that you want. And all this help is already available inside your IDE. So you should always use it. Next part of help is about this IDE itself, about the Text Studio. So if you want help about the Text Studio, then you should click on user manual. And again, you will get all the help that you require for the Text Studio. So if you want to look at different things, for example, editing text, spacing, inserting a list, table, and all those things, you can simply come to here and you will find all the help that you want. And lastly, you have this package help. So if I click on package help, it will ask me that which package I want to know about. Let us say I want to know about full page package. I will type full page and I will click on open. Okay, so it is taking some time. Yeah, now it is open, you can see that. Okay, so this package is now available for you to view how to use and all the details. So this is very, very handy whenever you want to look at some details about the package that you are using. Okay, so I will again stop for maybe 1 or 2 minutes if you want to ask anything.
This command begin figure and end figure, will it also appear itself or you have written it?
Yeah, that I did whenever, as I told you, I didn't actually write it. What I did was that I went to the wizard and then I clicked on insert graph. Okay. All these things were inserted for me by this particular option.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So let us
Dr. Abhinav, Vishal here, can you tell me how to write the page numbers? This option, it somebody said that it comes in options somewhere, but I am not able to find that. In options, configure Text Studio.
Yeah.
Then where to find all line numbers, I am not able to find it.
These line numbers are you talking about on the left hand side?
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. So you go to option, you go to configure Text Studio.
Okay.
And there you click on editor.
Editor, okay.
Yeah. Now you can see.
Okay. Fine. I got it. Yeah. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, my question is that I told that instead of default Adobe Reader, you have to use Sumatra PDF. So can you show me where to change it in the option in the team thing, Text Studio?
You don't actually have to do it. I will show you where to change, but you don't have to actually do it. What I'm only saying is, don't open your PDF file using Acrobat Reader when you are editing your tech document. That is all I'm saying. You let it be let it be installed in your system.
Foxit Reader?
I'm not sure about Foxit Reader, whether it allows or not. But ever if you encounter this problem that it says that LaTeX is not able to write your PDF file, that means you are using some software which is not allowing you to do that. So the best practice is not to use any software. Don't use any software. All the options are available inside your text studio, because you can see that on the right hand side your PDF will automatically appear. Therefore, it is not necessary to open the PDF file in any software, just to be on the safe side. Okay, so now let us go to this particular toolbar. I hope I have answered the question correctly. Acha, one question was how to change the option. So again, you can go to option, you can go to configure text studio, and there you can see commands. On the commands, what you can see is that here you see external PDF viewer. So if you want to change, then you can change from this particular option. Okay, so that is how you change it.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so now let us talk about the toolbar. Again, I will not go into too much of details because these are pretty standard toolbars. One of the most important button is here of the whole IDE. Whatever text studio you are using, this is the most important button, and it can be accessed through the shortcut of F5. So whenever you click that, it will compile your document and show you the PDF file, the output. Another important thing is this one, which is view, which is again accessed by F7, which shows you or which displays the PDF file. Now there are other important things which are shown over here, but I think these will be covered whenever we will be talking about typesetting the text and typesetting the equations. So whenever that is being done, then this backslash left, backslash right, and all these things will be covered. This part, label, tiny, and all those things will be covered by Dr. Sunil and Dr. Arvind. So I will not go into details of all this, but there is something very important that I want to show you, and I think it is very, very good feature which is available in Text Studio. So you can see that I have this tabular environment. Now what I will do is I will select this whole tabular environment and I will come and click here. You can see that it says align columns. Now if I align columns, then you can see that now my tabular environment has been aligned. Now this is my first column, first Abhinav, then there is the separator, then second Pratap, and then there is another separator, then surname and Singh. Okay, now it has aligned. Now what I want to do is, let us say that after this second, I want to insert another column here. Now inserting column in LaTeX is very problematic, but this IDE provides this great feature where if you click here, you can see that it says add column. Now if I press here, then you can see that it will insert the code for me. Now what I can say is that random, let us say, and I type here text. Okay, now this is very, very handy whenever I want to edit my table, whenever I want to include columns, remove columns, or include rows, remove rows, and all those things. So now if I click here, then you can see that another column has appeared. So this option, these particular options are very, very helpful as far as I am concerned. Okay, so this is all about the toolbar. Again, I'll stop for 1 or 2 minutes if you want to ask anything.
So my figure is not appearing, but caption is there.
What did you write in the figure case? What, in this particular line, what did you write? Backslash include graphics.
Yes, the same.
No, you should not write the same. That is the point, because you don't have this figure.
I have written the same. I have just click on the wizard and choose the file which I want to put here.
So that's okay. If it is not appearing right now, just wait. Whenever we will talk about figures, we will cover all these details so that you know that why your figure is not appearing.
Okay.
So for the time being, let us.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, just let me answer the previous question. Whether you use this use package graphics in your preamble?
Yes, sir. I have used it.
Okay. So maybe we can discuss it later on. Yeah. What was the next question?
So actually the line number 4th and 5th, they were displayed priorly, but after editing a lot of things or trying a lot of things, now they are not getting displayed in the PDF.
Okay, so that is okay. Again, as I'm saying, that whenever you will create your first document, whenever in the practice session, you will again encounter these problems, and we will handle those problems right now. As I said, that my motive here is just to display the features that are available in this particular software. Okay, don't worry if your figure is not appearing, if your text has disappeared, you are wondering what has happened. Don't worry about it right now.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so let us go to the next part. What is the next part? For example, you must be seeing this side panel which I had hidden previously. Okay. So if I can show this here, then I'm working right now on this particular second document I'm working on, right? You can see here. Let me see what I wanted to cover first. Okay, so you want to make your text bold and all those things, right? So what you do, for example, in Word is that, let us say that you want to make this particular text in bold. You either press Control B, you can try Control pressing B right now. So if I press Control B, then you can see that it has automatically inserted the command for me, which is exactly as Word. So if I run this particular document, then you can see that that Word is now appearing in bold. As you can see here, there is another option. For example, I can click somewhere here. You can see that it says boldface. This says italics. If I press here, then if I run, then you can see that it has changed that particular word to italics. So this word-like features are available here. You can change the alignment also, whether you want it justified, left align, right align, things like that, which are available down below. Okay, these things are available, and I'm not going into too much of details of all this, but there is some support for mathematics also and things like that. So these options are available. Now what happens is, now let us discuss about this structure and all the buttons which are available over here. Okay, so the first option is structure, which obviously shows the structure of the document. So let me go to a little bit more complex document, which is this document known as article. Okay, it is a rather simple document, but it has section, subsection, and all those things, because I want to highlight that what are the options which are available in this structure tab. So in this structure tab, as you can see, that it shows you that where your figures are. You can see that as I click here.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Sir, sorry, I'm really sorry for interrupting you, but I'm asking, this might be a silly question. For example, here you have written down that use package, okay?
Yeah.
Then a certain package name, I mean within bracket.
Yeah.
So my question is here that if that particular package is not installed in the MikeText console,
yeah,
then will it be installed automatically? Or do I need to get back to the MikeText again and I need to install it over there? Thank you very much, sir.
It can work both ways. It can install by itself also, automatically also, and it can get installed. You can get it installed by going to the MikeText console also. It can happen both ways. So you don't have to worry about it. Okay,
thank you very much, sir.
But internet is required. That is the crucial part. You require the internet. Okay, so you can go to figures, you can go to equations also. As you can see, that you can cycle through the equations by using these features. So you can go to labels, you can go to different sections also. So I have prepared two sections. One is for physicists and another one is for mathematicians. And if I click here, even in the sections also, I can go to the subsections. For example, my first subsection is about Albert Einstein. The second one is for Isaac Newton. Now you can see that I can see Albert Einstein written right here, but Isaac Newton is somewhere else. So if I click here, then I can straight away go to this particular subsection. So it helps you to move around the document very fast and in a much more efficient way. So therefore, this structure is very, very important for your use whenever you are considering this LaTeX, using LaTeX. Okay. So this is there. Next, if I go to this particular tab, then what it says is, if you can see, it says bookmarks. What is the meaning of bookmark? Let us say I want to always, for example, if I have to add new package, then what I have to do is I have to always go to the start of the document and then insert this / use package command. Instead of doing that, what I can do is I can simply click here, for example, line number 5. If I click here, then you will see that it has created this one. This is the bookmark number 1. Okay. Now what I do is, if I am somewhere else in the document, and now if I realize, okay, I have to go back there again, then what I do is either I can click here, it will take me to that particular bookmark, or what I can do is I can click, you can see that the bottom right corner, again, you will see go to bookmark number 1. If I click there, it will again take me to that particular bookmark. Okay, so this bookmark is similar to the bookmarks that we use in our textbooks or books. Okay, where we want to go back to a certain page number again and again, therefore we put a bookmark, and similarly you can put a bookmark here also. But if you want to remove that bookmark, you have to again click here, that will remove the bookmark. All these bookmarks are available in this particular tab. Okay. Now I will suggest that you explore all these tabs. For example, if I click here, you see that there are so many mathematical symbols which are now available for your ready reference. There are other things also which I'm not going to cover, but it will be very, very helpful for you, at least initially. Okay, so this was regarding the structure. Okay, so again, I will stop for 2 minutes if you want to ask anything. If there is something that is not clear to you.
Sir, you are speaking really very well, and your explanation is really, really very clear to us.
Achha, thank you
very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. All right. Actually what happens is that I don't want to, or at least I don't use this structure too much. So what I can do is I can go to this bottom left hand side, and if I click there, then you can see that I am now more focused on my source code and on my output. Okay, you can focus even more if you press F11. So if I press F11, then you can see that all the top and bottom part is also gone, and now only my IDE and the output is now available. So these options are available. So I will again press F11 so that everything shows up. Okay. All right. So now let us come to some very important other things. Let us first talk about this particular part, which is our main, where we are writing our source code. Okay. So if I compile this file, let me compile this file. Now you can see that our sample article has appeared here. Okay. All these, there are some figures, there are some text and everything. Okay. Now let us say that I am working here on the section mathematicians, but the PDF is showing me the first page. I want to go to that particular part of the PDF. So what I do is I right click and I say that go to PDF. And you can see that it has taken me to that particular part of PDF where that section is there. So this is very helpful. I find it very, very helpful. Okay. So that is one feature. Let me see other features as well that I want to cover. The next one is, feature that I want to explain to you, which I hope that you will like very much, is that you click everything and you right click it, and then you go to preview selection. Now you see that your equation has actually appeared. All right. The final form of the equation that has appeared. Now let us say you want to edit this equation. So what you can do is you can straight away go here and edit it. And when you edit it, you will see that you will see the simultaneous change down also. Okay. Now this equation is incorrect. So let me make it correct. So what it will do is it will simultaneously change everything in the preview also. Okay, now it is the correct equation. So you can just edit the PDF, you can just edit the equation as you will do in a Word document, and your output will appear simultaneously. Now let us say that I am happy with this equation. I don't want to make any changes, but I don't want to see all this. So what I do is I right click and then I say clear inline preview. Okay, now you can see that the equation is now gone. And this is true not only for this particular part, but it is true for almost every part. You can see your equation is your table is also appearing here. And if you want to make any kind of changes to the table, all these changes will be appearing simultaneously. For example, let me write here Albert. All right, Isaac Newton. So you can see all the changes you can see simultaneously with this preview feature. And when you are happy with the things, you can go right click and clear inline preview. Okay, so this is very, very helpful whenever, because one problem with LaTeX is you write the code, but you don't get the output right away. But here you can see that you can actually write the code and see the output right away. So that is, this is a very good feature of this particular IDE. Okay, so next one I want to show you is code folding. If my voice is not clear, what I want to show you is code folding as I have written here. Okay, so what is meant by code folding is, for example, if you have a very large piece of paper and you want to manage it, how do you manage it? You manage it by folding into several folds. So same thing you can do here also. For example, you can see that if I click here, then what will happen is that the bottom code has completely gone. Okay, and focus on the line numbers. You have here 45, 46. Now the line number is 52. That means 47, 48, 49, 50, 51. All of them have been folded. And that is why this vertical line has been drawn. If I want to see the tabular environment again, I click here again. And the code appears. Now let us say that I am done discussing about the physicist, let us say. So let me just show the side panel and I go to physicist. Okay, now I click here, you can see this particular button. Okay, if I click here, then you can see that after the section on physicist, several lines are gone and the next section is now of mathematicians. Okay, and again, there is this horizontal line. You can see, you can look at the page number also, sorry, line number. Line number is showing 15 and then you have 57. That means every text that was contained in this particular section has been folded up. Work document, and you see that there are two sections and finally you have end document. So this folding helps very, very much whenever you are working on a very large document. Okay. So that is what code folding is. Another very important feature is that if you hover your mouse over something, it shows you the output. For example, if I hover mouse here, you can see that the actual picture has appeared, right? So this tooltip is very, very good for you. Okay, whenever you have a lot of figures and you are not sure if that is the figure that you were looking for, you just go and leave your mouse there for some time and that figure will appear there. So this is a very good feature for you and it will help you a lot just by hovering over something. It works for many things. I have not tried it too much, but I think it works for a lot of things. Yeah, you can see that even the equations are appearing by itself. Okay, just when you go to begin equation and you hover your mouse over there, it will show you what your equation will look like. Okay, so I think it is an absolutely wonderful feature of this tooltip, which you can use all the time. The same thing you can do for references and all those things also. I think it works for references also. For example, if I go here, if I press my control button, all right, and I click on this, then it will take me to that particular equation. So this way you can jump around very easily. Okay, so this is what I wanted to discuss about the editor. Again, I will wait for 2 minutes if you want to ask anything.
So how the figure appears in the code itself?
You just have to go to that particular figure where your name is written. You leave your mouse over there and the figure will appear. Don't disturb the mouse.
But I can't see.
Because it might be not be there in your hard drive. That may be the problem, or the path may be wrong.
No, figure has appeared on the PDF, but by holding the mouse, I
don't
can't
hold
see
your mouse. No, you don't have to press there. You have to simply go there, leave your mouse there, remove your mouse. It's okay if it is not working right now. You can try it later on. That's okay.
Okay.
Sir, excuse me. Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening. Please go ahead.
Sir, where the PDF are being saved? Yeah. Where is the location on my hard disk?
The location will be where you saved your tech file. That will be the location of your PDF file also.
Okay. Could you please be kind to go? On your computer.
That's okay. You can see that I have created this day one folder. Okay. So you can see that you can see this file, right? First document.pdf. Right? And you can see the tech file also there. First document.tech.
Okay.
Yeah. If I click on this, then it will open my file. Okay. But
okay,
I will
sir.
Suggest you don't do that right now. Please don't do that because it may create some problem for you.
Okay. This is not the right moment to ask this question, but my question is that when I am going to submit my paper to some journal, I need to submit actually part by part, right? I'm talking about submitting my journal in Elsevier Science Direct. Okay.
Yeah.
They are providing me certain sort of option. That your introduction, please keep here. Methodology, plus keep here. Your literature review, keep here. This sort of option actually they are giving me. They are not actually telling me to upload the whole document by once. Right, sir?
No. Actually, you can upload your tech file all at once. You don't have to do that. Yeah.
But for what file actually I need to do that part by part? But for tech file, it's not like that, right, sir?
No, it is not such for tech file. For tech file, what you have to do is you have to upload your covering letter, which will be separate. You have to upload your figures, which will be separate. You will have to upload your tech file at once. You don't have to submit it in parts. You have to upload your tech file at once.
Okay. So thank you very much, sir. And sorry for disturbing. Thank you very much.
No, it's okay.
Okay. Sir, can you show that part of bookmarking again?
Yeah, let us say I want to go to this begin document, right? So it is on line number 11. So what I do is I take my cursor here between this part and line number 11 and I click there. Okay, so it has selected the line. That is not what I want. Let me go to the left and then click again. Now you see that this bookmark symbol has appeared. So that means now it is bookmark number 1. If I want to create another bookmark, let us say at this particular section, I will click here again. And now you can see that it is 2 written here. That means this is my bookmark number 2. So that is how you create bookmarks.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sir, for the figures to incorporate, we need to keep the figure in the working directory itself, or you can give the path.
Yeah, please wait. You can keep it in your working directory. You can give the path. These things we will cover later on. It is not a part of actual text to read. Okay. It's
thank
okay.
You,
we will cover all these things.
Thank you.
Okay. So let me go to this part of PDF where we are viewing our PDF. In this PDF, what options are available to us is this one, external viewer. If you want to open in some other software, for example, Adobe Reader or Sumatra PDF or whatever PDF you are using, you can click on that. So it will open that file in that particular part. So you can try this later on. And there are some options you can move around with pages. If you click this button, you can go to the start, or you can go to the end of the document using these buttons, which are fairly straightforward. In this one option I want to show you, which I think is very, very good. As you can see on the PDF, there is lots of margin here. And when I'm writing my document, I don't care for these margins. What I want is my text should appear in the maximum possible space. So that space, that option is available here, where you can see that it says fit to text width. If I click there, then what it will do is it will zoom on PDF such that just my, actually it is not working right now because I changed some settings, but what it does is it zooms such that only my text is appearing and my margins are gone. This you can try later on, but I think it is a very, very useful option. Okay, so this was that. And okay, there is another very important concept here. As I showed you that on the left hand side, what you can do is you can click and say go to PDF. But what if I am on the PDF? For example, let us say I'm here and I want to edit something. Then what I will do is I will right click and I will say go to source. So if I click that, then what it will take me where my source is. Okay, this is where my source is. So you can jump back and forth between the two. Here you say go to PDF, here you say go to source. There are various other showing options that you can see. For example, if I go here show and I say content, then it says for the time being there is no TOC because I didn't create any. But if there was any table of content, it will show here. There are other showing options which you can explore by yourself. All right. So I am just about to end. I will take maybe 5 minutes more just to introduce you to the shortcuts. So what are the what I personally think are one of the most useful shortcuts for this particular software. So for this particular piece of software. So first one is, let me write it over here. First piece is F5 and F7. So can someone tell me what does F5 do?
Compile
and
it builds and view.
Build and view, exactly. So if you want to compile your file and if you want to view, then it will compile and view. And what does F7 do?
Simply view PDF.
Exactly. So keep this in mind. It will help you a lot. Okay. Next one is Control N, Control O, Control S. Now, can someone tell me what they will do? Control N, for example, Control N, what that will do?
New untitled document will open.
Yeah, exactly. What will Control O do? Control O.
Open file.
What will Control S do?
Save it.
Save file. Yeah, exactly. So I hope it is self-explanatory. Okay. Next one is Alt P. So what is Alt P? I select everything. I press Alt P. So it is giving you the preview. All right.
Yes.
So it will help you. For example, if you don't want to select, if you don't want to right click and select live preview, then you can simply press Alt P. If you want it to disappear, then you have to go to right click and clear inline preview. Okay. So Alt P is another very good shortcut. Acha. So let me ask you, what can you guess what Control I will do? Control I.
For italics.
Italics. What will Control B do? Control B.
Bold.
Yeah. So these are pretty standard things, right? Next one is Control Shift I. Acha, before Control Shift I, there is another very important, which is Control E. What Control E does is it inserts environment. For example, let us say I want to insert an environment called center. So what I do is you just look at my text editor. So I press Control E. You see what happened. Okay. Now I'm not doing anything. I'm just typing now center. So now what it does is you can see that not only it has said begin center, it has also said end center. Okay. Now I want to jump to this particular part. So either I can use mouse, but instead of using mouse, I am pressing control right arrow. So let us press control right arrow. Control right arrow. You can see that it has gone to that particular part and it has selected it. Right? So that is, these are two very good shortcuts. One is control E and the another one is control right arrow. You will find this control right arrow very, very important. Why? Let me show you. So let me write some mathematics here. We will explain to you how to write mathematics. You don't have to worry right now. But let me write some mathematics in dollar signs and I say backslash frac. When I write backslash frac, you can see that it is giving me option. Now what I simply do is I press enter. Okay. So now it is asking me to insert numerator. So let me write A upon B. So I will simply type A. Now what I want to do is I want to jump to the next next basis. So what I do is I press control right arrow. Control right arrow. Now you can see it has selected everything. Now I simply press B. Okay. I can again press control right arrow to go here. Okay. So this control right arrow is very, very important to jump around whenever you encounter such situations. Okay. So this is another important thing that I wanted to discuss. And control T and control U, I have already discussed. What control T does is that it toggles comment. You select all three, you press control T. It will comment out everything. You press control U, it will uncomment it. Okay, so that is control T, control U. These are very, very important commands for me. Another one is control shift I. When you will create list that we will talk later on. For example, let me just insert some list. I go control right. And now I say control shift I. As soon as I press control shift I, it will introduce backslash item for me automatically. Okay. Why this is required? You will see that whenever you want to introduce new elements, you always have to type backslash item. So you can simply press control shift I. It is very, very handy for me when I am working with lists. We will discuss all these things later on whenever we will talk about lists. So don't worry about it. Okay. A bookmark I have already shown you, huh? But are there any shortcuts for bookmarks? Yes, there are shortcuts. So let me just create a bookmark here. At mathematicians, and I will make another bookmark here at Leonard Euler. Now I am, let us say, somewhere else. I am working somewhere else. I want to go to my first bookmark. I will press control 1. It will take me to my first bookmark. Okay. So can you guess how to jump to the bookmark number 2? Can you guess?
Control 2.
Control 2, exactly. Control 2. Okay. So you get the idea? That control 1 takes you to first bookmark. Control 2 takes you to the second bookmark and so on. Okay, now I'm going to show you some magic here. I thought that I can perform some magic also for you guys. So let me show you that feature. So let us say that I'm trying to create some sections and subsections. For example, I want to talk about physicists. I want to talk about Albert Einstein. I want to talk about Isaac Newton. Okay, now, the command to create section subsection is backslash section and backslash subsection. So what I should write it like this. Backslash section, then I put a brace here, then I go to the end of the topic, and then I have to close that brace. Okay. And I have to do the same thing here. I have to type backslash subsection, then insert this particular brace, opening brace, then I have to type closing brace. And it can be very tiresome. For example, I can do for maybe 2, but if I add more, for example, Maxwell or things like that, then things can get very, very difficult to type everything all the time. Okay. So what I do is this, just notice what is happening here. All right. So first I will show you, then I will tell you how I did that. So just wait for 2 minutes. seconds. Now just notice what is happening. So this is the magic that I wanted to demonstrate, that you can see that for all the lines, I wrote backslash subsection, I started the braces, I end the braces, everything I did simultaneously. Okay, so this is known as block selection. For example, let us say that I changed my mind. I said, I will make a section of all this. Of all these scientists, I will make a section. So now you can notice what is happening here. I select sub, I delete them. Now you can see that all of them are section. Okay, so this is again known as block selection. Now, how to do that? So what I will request you to do is, I will request you to make some kind of a list, something like this, so that you can do it for yourself. A list, something like this. Just wait for a second. Okay, let us write something. You can write some random text, that's okay. Please go ahead, write 4 or 5 things. For example, you can make a grocery list, what you want to buy today. Big tomato, small tomato, long, whatever you want to buy. Okay, I hope you are ready with at least 2-3 items. Okay, now what I want you to do is listen carefully. You just go to your first item and click the cursor here. Okay, and now you press Control Alt. Please press Control Alt and keep pressing it. Okay, now go to the second item and click at the starting. Now go to the third item and click and keep doing it for all the items. Okay, you should get something like this. Once you are done, you can release the button, but don't press anywhere. Okay, so now the cursor must be appearing everywhere. Now you start typing whatever you want to type. For example, backslash, subsection. Okay, I will start the brace because it ends automatically for me. So I will delete the last one because I want it to go to the end. Okay, now what I press is, on your keyboards, there must be a button called end. You go and press that button, end. You go to the end and you close the brace. Okay, once you are done, then you can click somewhere else. So just do that.
Sir, please repeat it. Pardon.
Okay, I will try again. So let me just undo that. I'm here, all right? Now hold Control Alt, keep holding it. Okay, now first go to the starting of the first one, then press and hold Control Alt, keep holding it. Okay?
So yes, Control Alt?
Control Alt, A-L-T Alt.
Okay, Control Alter, okay. And the, I mean the down key, I mean down arrow.
Not down arrow, but you click with your mouse.
Okay.
You click with your mouse at the starting.
Okay, okay.
I'm choosing just 3 just for demonstration purpose. And now you do whatever you want to do. You type whatever you want to type. So are you able to get the achieved result or not?
After what we'll do, sir? After
holding control. After you have placed all your cursor, then you can release Control Alt and you type backslash, let us say subsection. Okay. You start your brace, you close the closing brace, you go to the end, and then you type again.
Yes, sir, it's working, sir. Thank you.
So can you just hang on for a minute? Yeah. Yeah, so I hope you got the idea that how useful it can be. Okay, for example, let me just show you one more example which where I think you will find it very, very useful is when you are creating some item. So let me say that I want to create an itemized list. Okay, and what I want to do is that let us say item one. Okay, then I go item two and so on. But as you know that when you create itemized list, then you have to also type backslash item. So what I do is I press Control Alt, I press here, then I press here, and I type backslash item. That's it. Now your itemized list is ready. So if I click here, then you will see that my list is appearing here. Okay, so this helps you very, very much. This is known as block selection. So that is it what I planned for today. If you want to ask anything, then please go ahead.
Sir, excuse me, this again might be a silly question, but in LaTeX, sir, is there any kind of option so that I can save my LaTeX document as what file?
There are certain other softwares which are available where you can convert your LaTeX document to the Word file. But we have limited choice of things that we can discuss, so we are not discussing that right now. But there are options, yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Sir, another question. Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Sir, for my analytical research purposes, as I am on the field of finance, yeah. I need to regularly work with R and Python.
Yeah.
So from some of my colleagues, I came to know that it is possible to write down the whole article within R using LaTeX within R. Is that so, sir?
Yeah, that can be the case, but it is not a good idea actually, because you don't want a sword to sew some clothes, right? You should use the right tools for the right purpose. Thing will be to actually write your code in R or whatever figure you want to create from R. You export it in some kind of PDF or PNG format and then include in LaTeX, because then you can't use Text Studio, or there are many things which will create some problem for you. Yes, that can be done. Yeah, that I agree.
Okay, sir. So the thing I'm actually asking from you is that it is possible to export my R output into LaTeX, right?
Yeah, you have to simply export it in the form of PDF or PNG, and then you can simply include it as a form of a figure.
Isn't there any kind of other option available?
Like what you want to achieve?
I mean, for example, I have simply, got some result out of R. So it's not wise actually to simply import it. Simply import it within LaTeX as a PNG file. Rather, if I can import it within my PNG file as a text file, then it will be possible for me to edit afterwards. Just like I can simply copy paste my Excel file into the Word so that afterwards I can edit it. Are you getting my point, sir?
For whatever output that you've got, that is not in the form of graphs, you are saying that it is in the form of some text, right? That is what you're saying?
Okay, so let me clarify again. If I get my output in Excel file, then I can simply copy and paste that Excel file within my Word file. Okay, and if necessary, I can edit that Excel file within the Word file later on. So just like that, if I simply import the analytical portion of the result of my analysis from R to the LaTeX, just in a PNG format, then it will not be possible to edit them afterwards. That is
what I'm asking, whether it is an image that you want to import, whether it is some kind of a text you want to import, what you want to import.
Sir, it's actually the output, analytical part, result. So it's wise to, it's better for me to import them not as an image, but as a text file. Is it possible here in LaTeX?
I think you mean to say that you have made some graphs after some analysis, and that is what you want to import. And you
so not only graphs, but also some analysis, some numbers, some tables.
Yeah. Then in that case, it is you have to write the LaTeX document. Yeah, you have to write the LaTeX document. You have to create your tables. You have to create your equations in LaTeX. That you can do. And as far as image is concerned, that you have to insert in the form of a PNG or PDF or whatever is suitable for you.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much, sir. And your lecture is really very much extraordinary for us. Within a very short period of time, you have explained so many things to us. So my heartiest gratitude to you. Will you please be kind to share your email address and WhatsApp contact so that we can be in your touch for the rest of our life for academic purposes only?
It is always available, I think. It is if you are in the WhatsApp group, my number is there. My email is available at the Institute website.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your kind consideration. Thank you very much.
Sir, I wanted to ask you something. Suppose what happens is we start a section or a paragraph and it supposedly starts in one page and ends in another page. So if it's an itemized list and we want to avoid that, how do we like directly move the section to the next page?
Yeah, please wait when we are talking about text editing. We will explain all these things. Please wait for some time. If you have any question regarding the software, then I will be happy to answer right now.
Sir, is there any kind of option to introduce space break, just like we can introduce in Word?
Yes,
we can. For example, I mean, it is possible here. Okay. Sir, a request, if you please be kind to us, would you please be kind to share the text file, the LaTeX files with us here in the WhatsApp group or in email, please?
So actually, we can practice at home. Yeah, what we want to do is we will ask you to create the files yourself. So it will always be available with you. Okay.
Okay. And yes, sir, definitely I will. But due to the internet connectivity problem, actually some noise is being created over there. That's why if I can get your file just for a reference of mine, it will be, I mean, a bit helpful for me in this very introductory level.
Sure. We will share all the files that you want. Sure. Okay. No problem.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir, can you please repeat how to change the font size and font type?
Again, don't worry about it right now, please. We will cover all these things. We will ask you to do all these things by yourself. You will do it by your hands. So you don't have to worry right now about it. Yeah?
Okay, thank you.
Sir, I'm not able to put the bookmark. Can you please repeat about the bookmark?
Okay, let me try once more. So here you can see the text editor, right? Okay. So if I click, you can see that it says something here and your line number is somewhere here. If I click very close on the right hand side of this, then you can see that it will create the bookmark. Is it okay?
Actually, sir, in the text editor, there will be between two lines. Structure is there in between two columns.
What is there between two columns? Sorry?
The left alignment, that is bold, italic, yeah. View. Yeah. But here is another column. Written here is bibliography, education, and that means my the text file.
Like this?
Yes.
So what is your question?
How can we insert the bookmark?
So all right, so you can see that right after here where you see bold, italics, U, etc. Just right click there, it will create a bookmark there. You see?
Okay, but is okay? There is no numbering, that means 1, 2, 3, 4 in the text file.
Yeah, this symbol is appearing.
No, sir. Actually, there is a numbering, that means line number 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, but in my text file, there is no numbering.
It's okay. Don't worry about numbering right now. Are you able to create this bookmark or not? That is what I'm asking.
Yes.
That's
yes,
okay. That was the question.
Okay. Thank you.
Sir, my question is that can you show me if there how the errors will pop up? If there are any errors when we compiling or anything, how the errors will be displayed in the Text Studio?
Okay. So for example, let me delete this and run this file. You can see that it is now showing you the errors at the bottom. Okay. If I click on that, then it will take me to that particular error. If I correct that error and then rerun, then it's okay. The error will be shown in this particular where you see your messages and everything. There you will find your errors also.
So this, in that case, that error will be rectified itself, or we have to make it manually?
No, you have to. It will not rectify itself. Otherwise, it will not display any errors. It will rectify itself and run the document again. You have to rectify the error by yourself.
Okay, is there any other question?
Sir, hello.
Yes, please.
So since I am very much new to LaTeX, I am not able to perform simultaneously what you are doing. So all these things we repeated in the tutorial sessions also.
Yes, all these. Actually, these first two lectures, they are just the overview of the LaTeX.
Yeah, my concentration is only to listen to you, what you are saying.
Yeah. So from the next lecture, we will start with some topics by top. We will go topic by topic, and then along with that, we have the tutorial session and all that. Okay, so don't worry. This was just an overview. So we will.
Because that did quite difficult to do.
Yeah. So we are assuming that all are the victims.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So I think what we now we can take a break of 1 hour, and for the next lecture, we will join at 2 p.m. and we will use the same Google Meet link with which you have joined at present for the lecture at 2 p.m. and that will be by Dr. Sunil Dutt. Okay, so thank you all.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Sir, assignment
very much for such excellent lecture.
Sir, assignment is arrived on an email ID.
Yeah, so, I have entered.